An aurora is one of nature's most spectacular visual phenomena, bright lights dancing across the night sky. The brightest auroras are concentrated in rings called the aurora ovals around the north or south poles. The auroras in the northern hemisphere are called aurora borealis. Southern lights are called aurora australis. Australis comes from the Latin word for southern. Auroras are the result of events that begin on the sun millions of kilometers away from the Earth. The sun is so hot that high energy plasma electrons and protons can escape from the sun's gravitational field, and this is what's called the solar wind. When the sun is relatively inactive, the solar wind travels at about 300 to 400 kilometers per second. When the sun is more active, eruptions can occur which release dense plasma or plasma clouds into the solar wind. These plasma clouds carry magnetic field structure from the sun to the Earth at speeds up to 2,000 kilometers per second, and that's what we call a solar storm. The solar wind has enough energy that it could strip away the Earth's atmosphere over time. However, we're lucky we have the Earth's magnetic field, which is caused by hot, electrically charged molten rock, which is swirling around in the outer core of the Earth. The interaction of the solar wind with this magnetic field creates a protective cavity called the magnetosphere, which deflects most of the particles from the solar wind. However, during a solar storm, the fast-flowing plasma temporarily deforms the magnetosphere, causing a buildup of energy on the night side of the Earth. When conditions are right, this energy is released, accelerating charged particles so they spiral around the magnetic field lines towards the north and south pole. When these particles reach the upper atmosphere, they collide with neutral atoms of oxygen and nitrogen. And during these collisions, the charged particles transfer energy to the atoms, exciting the electrons to higher energy levels. When the electrons return to their original energy level, the atoms release this energy in the form of light, and at various different wavelengths, and the wavelengths determine the color of the light. Which color is emitted, that depends on how energetic the collisions are and where they occur in the atmosphere. Oxygen releases greenish yellow or red light, nitrogen dark red or blue light. And then these colors can mix so that we see purples, pinks, and white light. And that's what makes these beautiful lights.